was not a mindless dramatic act of a group of madmen, but a conscious though tragic political decision made by the legal government of Poland. Having experienced two cruel occupations, German and Soviet, the Poles were clearly aware of what was on the Soviet agenda. They knew that the Red Army, approaching from the east, was fighting not to liberate Poland, but to exchange Nazi totalitarianism for their own communist totalitarian regime. The Warsaw Rising was also an attempt by Polish forces. Soviet troops.
Thank you.
the night of August 5th to 6th, Elżbieta Ostrowska, known as Ella, traveling from Śródmieście to Mokotów, opened a regular sewer route between the districts. The underground network of corridors made it possible to maintain links between individual sites of combat, to transfer casualty replacements, supply food and ammunition, and to evacuate the insurgent units, civilians, and the wounded cut off by the enemy. The insurgents very quickly adapted the most important routes for regular traffic. In many places, they fixed wooden boards on the floor, attached ropes to the walls, and marked the direction of traffic, even using illuminated signs. Maintaining efficient communication links via the sewers was the responsibility of a specially trained group of women liaison officers, kanałówki, meaning sewer girls, and young boys, including a team of so-called sewer rats. Before the Germans worked out what was happening, the traffic on the underground routes was heavy, and the sewers were the safest way to get around the city. However, in the middle of August, the enemy began to destroy the sewer routes. The Germans fitted iron barriers and passages, bricked up tunnel entrances, released gas into the sewers or dammed them. They also blew up some of the sewers using vehicles filled with explosives.